This tutorial will show how to use SAP2000's powerful interactive database editing command to modify model data in a tabular form, a strong complement to the graphical approach. We start by going to the Edit Interactive Database Editing command. And note that the form shows the model definition tables that are available for editing. For this model, there are 45 different tables that may be edited. We will select Property Definitions and Connectivity Data. Click OK, and note that on the next form, on the drop-down list, there are 10 different tables that we can edit. Click on the Material Properties General table, and select the second row or steel property. Click the Copy button and then the Paste Append button to duplicate the previous row, which makes for easy and rapid generation of similar properties. Click on the Connectivity Frame option and select Row 1, or Frame Object 1. And note that the selected member is highlighted on the model with a blinking line. Next, click on Joint Coordinates. Again, if we select the first row, or Joint Object 1, the joint location is highlighted on the model by the blinking dot. Similar if we click on Joint 2. A right-click anywhere in the table will bring up a drop-down context-sensitive menu. For the coordinate type column, note that the calculator option is not available, as this is not a numeric input variable, but that the drop-down list is, which lists the available values for this variable based on previously defined input. A right-click in the X location column shows that the drop-down menu has the calculator option available because it is looking for numeric input. And if we click on it, the calculator form appears. In this form, we can type in complex formulas and the program will calculate the value and place it in the table. A left click on the unit button causes the units menu to appear. And a change from inches to feet units causes the column underneath to be instantly updated. Note that no changes made to the tables are applied to the model until the Apply to Model button is clicked. Click this button, and then Done, to see how the model was modified by the joint coordinate change. Return to the Interactive Database Editing command, and to the Joint Coordinates table that we just edited. This time, we will send the table out to Excel to edit by using the To Excel button. Here, we can make changes to the data in the spreadsheet. And without closing Excel, re-import the changes back into the SAP2000 table using the From Excel button. Although the table has been revised, it is important to remember that no changes made to the tables are applied to the model until the Apply to Model button is clicked. As a general rule, labels, such as the joint object IDs, should not be altered on the tables, as it will change the label for that table only, and references and other tables will not be updated. A better way to change labels is to go to the Edit Change Labels command, as this will change the names as well as update all references to the name. If we go to the File Export command, we see that there is an option to send out to an Excel spreadsheet. This differs from the export previously done with the joint coordinates table in that it sends out the entire model and not just a single table. Next, we will show how the interactive database editing command can make quick work of modifying applied loads. Start by selecting all of the joints on the right side of our four-story frame and go to the Assign Joint Loads Forces command and enter a lateral load of 10 kips in the negative X direction. You can see that this applies a uniform load. However, very often, lateral loads are applied in a more triangular distribution, such as to represent earthquake forces. To modify these loads, go to the Interactive Database Editing command and check the Joint Assignments box. Click OK. And then double-click in the F1 column for joint 9. Modify the load by multiplying the 10 kips by the fraction 4/5. Follow the same procedure for joint 8 and joint 7 by using fractions of 3/5 and 2/5, respectively. Apply these changes to the model by clicking on the Apply to Model button. And note how the applied loads have changed. This was considerably quicker and easier than selecting each individual joint object and assigning the appropriate values. This concludes this tutorial on interactive database editing.